They are addressing themselves in public. They are running mad. God has given us the power.
Amen.
Your life is a life of victory. And what you must give out is victory. So this week God is sending us on a certain level where we are not only going to be delivered, but we are going to get at that portion of power to deliver others. I believe after this week, even at our prayer time in the evening, the altars in your village, the altars in your father's house, the altars in your area where you come from, they are going to be destroyed by fire in the name of Jesus. So that when you sleep, they can also sleep. So that when you enjoy food, they can enjoy food. Your sisters, your brothers must enjoy what you enjoy today. But the Bible says, how can they be? How can they know? Until someone has told them. And how can they tell them? Unless we are sent. And how can we be sent? Unless we are equipped. And sometimes we don't deliver other people because we are ignorant. Now don't think about witchcraft in the form of putting eggs around and some lizards. Don't think about witchcraft in that area. Forget about that. That's so weak. But witchcraft originates from the throne of the enemy. It can come in any form. Yes. You don't need to go to a shrine. Oh, they don't have to go to a shrine to exercise witchcraft. The power of the enemy. The power of the enemy. Is strong.
Gaman.
Is powerful.
Gaman.
The devil is not weak.
Satan is same enough.
The devil is strong.
Satan is one man.
The devil has power.
Alina man.
He has power to destroy.
Alina man yokuzikiza.
The devil has power to uproot you.
Alina man yokusigulia.
The devil has the power to disorganize your life.
Alina man yochankala
nyoka. The devil has the power to make you backward.
Alina man yokuzema.
He can destroy your destiny.
Sawa yokuzikiza magenda.
But the Bible says,
na yepa ibuli,
the Son of Man,
omwana wa Mungu,
manifested,
yalabisi,
to destroy the powers and the Bible says, all authority in heaven
Mokuru
and on earth
Nekosi
has been given to me.
Yes. Yes.
Given to me.
Remember
the scripture here. We'll go into this in the lunch hour and in our revival week. It is going powerful every evening. Luke chapter number 10 and verse number 19. Let's begin from there. Luke chapter number 10 and verse number 19. Behold, I have given you, send me.
Gamba mze.
Show them, send me.
Gamba mze.
Show them, send me.
Me.
Behold, I have given you authority to tread on serpents, on scorpions, and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt you. Come on, open up your Bible. Luke chapter number 10 verse number 19. I want you to read louder with your strong voice. Three, go. Behold, I give you authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt you. and no powers of darkness shall overcome my life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So all authority, see how powerful you are. I can look at all the guns. I can look all the fighting tanks. I can look all the grenades. Any kind of weapon. I have it. I am empowered. I am the authority. I can command. I can chase. I can destroy. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to you. Not to the pastor. But to you, and the Bible says, now you can go, and nothing will hurt you. In other words, the devil can lay his traps, but they will not attack you. They will not hurt you. They will not catch you. You are empowered as a child of God. You have the authority. When the enemy arises, you speak and say, in the name of Jesus, I command you. Has given you the authority and the power is in your life. My responsibility this week is to challenge you to rise up against every challenge. Whatever makes you to cry, whatever makes you to go backwards, whatever causes pain in your life, you rise against it with the authority of God.
Amen.
Do you know why? Because God knows that the enemy is powerful. That he says, no, don't worry. But greater is he that is in you. In Ephesians chapter number 6. Chapter number 6, I think, verse number 12.
He
goes on the weapons of our warfare.
They
are not carnal. They are not visible. They are not. When you confront
Juju
in the crossroads, you mean it seriously. And you step over them. You say, I was given authority to drop over you. You witchcraft. Whatever was done to destroy my going, I step on you. I have the power to drop over you. And the Bible says, nothing will hurt me. I am stepping on you. I am going forward. In the name of Jesus, I am stepping on you. I am going forward. Because greater, you must understand that the devil is powerful, but our God is greater. Is greater. And mighty. Now God is waiting for you to rise up. God is waiting for you to rise up. The authority he has given to you. He has given the power. He has given the authority. Rise up and use it. How do you use the authority which God has given to you? By the confession of your mouth. You speak to that mountain. You speak that situation. You let silence happen. Let me pray in my heart. There are times when praying in your heart doesn't work. Your co-wife must hear your voice. Your enemy must hear your voice. Your enemy must hear your utterance. You open up your mouth and say, devil, I come to you in the name of Jesus. Get out of my sight.
Amen.
The devil knows it very well that you are powerful, for he don't wrestle against flesh and blood. Do you know why? Those who come to the
kuchi.
Abamacho kuloga.
They sacrifice chicken.
Basadate nkoko.
They kill animals.
Bate nsoro.
They pour blood.
Bayi omusayi.
But the Bible says, we don't press against that blood. It's useless. It is powerless. Let them do what they can. We don't press against that. No! Our weapons are not carnal. We don't fight with the gossip. We don't fight with the quarreling. No! When the enemy rises up to quarrel with you, you say, greater is in me.
Yes.
You are too small for me to quarrel with you. You are too minor for me to fight you. If I quarrel with you verbally, I will be reducing myself to your level. But something that is invisible is going to twist your path.
I pray for you in the name of Jesus.
Silence the mouth of your enemy. We don't press against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic power over the present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil. In the heavenly places. Your mother-in-law, she's not the problem. Something somewhere there. Your boss is not the problem. There's something somewhere there. Your wife is not the problem. There's something somewhere there. In heavenly places. There's something about the sky. There's some spirit of darkness powers that are fighting you. But because the enemy does not use anything else, just as God uses human beings, so the enemy uses human beings. God uses people, so the enemy does. So that whoever is fighting you physically is not herself.
Yes, yo.
One of the symptoms of a demon-possessed person, they have supernatural powers. The word supernatural doesn't necessarily mean holy.
But in a man, a man,
extraordinary power that is not normal.
Power.
So one of the signs of a demon possessed person, even if they are meatless like
a man.
If the demons possess me, I can leave these two speakers up. Because in me I have that supernatural power that is not mine. Something possesses me. It comes and occupies my life. That's why when even you're praying for demon possessed person, even if she's a child of 8 years, if you're not energetic enough, that child can whip you. Because there is a power, there is a principality, there is a ritual of demons sitting on her. She's not herself. You go back home, you find your wife, she's looking at you like a young lion. Don't beat her. She knows. Begin to attack the principality. There are many in dwelling place. Some of us, the enemy has found a loophole to make us his dwelling place. But we can rise up. Whatever root is using to enter our lives, whatever channel is using to enter our lives, we can rise up. Stop hearing witch doctors. They are nothing. As long as you are in Christ, you can do all things. You can do all things. We did become born again.
again for a show.
Tetwalokoka kweraga.
We become born again to demonstrate the power of the kingdom of God.
Tetwalokoka tulaga manyego bakabaka bakati.
Therefore,
no rancho.
The world must know that the kingdom of God dwells in us.
Bakabaka bakatonda muri.
And whatsoever we command,
era mliche tulaga
must establish.
Tetwalokoka kunywezewa.
Yes.
Amen.
My slogan is I don't move, they move. I don't move, they move. Until I choose to move.
Why?
I walk with the establishment of God.
Amen.
I walk with the establishment of God.
Amen.
So children of God, as a church, God has called us. When everyone is running away from
Pallisa,
we will be established.
Amen.
We will be established.
Yes,
at the morning I was going to church and I stopped to buy newspapers with my some people in the car. So I met one of my friends there. I said, oh, my son, how are you?
Oh, tell me what,
I said, I'm fine.
Come on,
you know, my son, I'm planning to leave Pallisa. These people here, you see, now they're fighting themselves. And some of us
who
are foreigners will be the target very soon.
I said,
yeah, this for you.
You
can't go. I can't go now. You see now my children started from here. I gave some reasons.
You
see now I've made some establishments. So
when will you to me?
Oh, you can't go.
He
said, yeah, but you know, because I do also, I want to go this way, I want to go that way. Can you tell me? Cowards run away from the front line.
But in your mass.
The might of us. Progress. You know, our God is so powerful. He speaks louder in our ears. And he says, I can bless you in the village. It doesn't matter what conditions are there. As long as you trust in me. I can bless you there. I can bless you there. You walk on this street.
Those
new boutiques which are there.
Is a boutique.
None of them is a Mdeso. None of them is a Mgwe. They are all foreigners here. Like Mwesigwa. The
Mdeso
is a Mgwe. The
Mdeso is a Mgwe.
Not us. Let them run. But not us. We shall stay. We know that our God is not only in us, but is with us. Nothing can deter us from following Christ. One more scripture. James. John chapter. The letter of John.
By way of
John. Chapter verse of John chapter number 4 and verse number 4. The first letter of John chapter number 4 and verse number 4. Little children, you are from God and have overcome them. For he who is in
him
is greater than he who is in the world.
Amen.
You little children, we can be little in the sight of the enemy. But you know you are not the first.
Yes.
Even then looked so small. And
tied
before Goliath. But he didn't know that greater man, the great of the universe, was in a small boy. So little children, you are from God. John 1:12. That's where we are incorporated in the DNA of God. You little children, you are from God. Forget your clan now. When you go back to a clan, and they all sit down, tell them now, I am not coming to you. In the name of the Abakatikoko, Abakaduka, I am coming to you. In the name of my God, because I'm a child of God, I come to you. In the name of my God. James chapter number 4 and verse number 7. Submit yourself therefore to God. Resist the devil. And he will flee from you. James chapter chapter number 5 verse 7. Submit yourself to God. Resist the devil. And he will flee from you. Submit yourself to God. Resist the devil. And he will flee from you. Your victory lies on your dependence in God. Stand upon your feet. Your victory lies in your dependence on God. This week, we are going to